Rotor resistance control and slip power recovery schemes. Rotor resistance control can be seen from the slip for maximum torque. That maximum torque not only depends upon applied voltage, it can be also changed by changing the rotor resistance. This principle is used in this control in a slip ring induction motor, since it is possible only in slip ring induction motor. The characteristic of rotor resistance control is shown as a torque slip characteristics with a increasing, that is rotor resistance, the torque decreases. Rotor resistance control is simply applied through the slip rings and brushes. Three external resistances are connected. By varying these three external resistances, we can vary the rotor voltages and currents, hence the rotor speed, torque can be varied. The rotor resistance control is shown in a different way here. That is, instead of using three resistances which will bring in imbalance, we go in for a single resistance R with a chopper. So the slip power which is in the rotor is converted into DC by the hydraulic fair. It is then filtered using LD, and the chopper will take care of variation of voltage, and the load is connected across the chopper. So this R is a fixed resistance now. Instead of varying the resistance, you are varying the voltage of the in the rotor side, hence the speed and torque of the motor can be varied. Here we overcoming the case of imbalance, but in both the cases, since the resistance is used, the slip power is wasted as heat. To recover the slip power which is wasted at heat, Cramer proposed a system where the slip power is fed to a direct bridge rectifier, which is filtered, is fed back to the supply using a line commutator inverter, and is stepped up to the required voltage using a transformer. So this not only provided a variable speed control, but also did not waste the slip power as heat. It is effectively utilized or transferred back to the source. The problem with the system is only one way power is possible, that is from the rotor power to the supply. So subsynchronous operation was possible. We go to Scherpius system. Scherpius replaced the direct bridge rectifier connected to the rotor with a thyristor rectifier. Otherwise, the Scherpius and Cramer system are same. Due to this, power flow is possible in both the direction. Hence, we not only get the power from the rotor and control the speed at lower values using this Scherpius system, we can also feed back power into the rotor system from the supply. Hence, super synchronous operations can be easily achieved. This marks the end of the session. Thank you.